Dubb changed my life. I know it's changed my life, and I've shared that with Ruben so many times. And I don't know if any of that resonates with you. So identifying targets, who are we talking to? You know, developing an outreach program and attracting and engaging. Because one of the things that I love to do is attract and engage is always better than chase and convince. If you can be seen, be heard, and be talked about, you could start a conversation. And Dubb is the easiest way to start a conversation. And I'm passionate about Dubb. And some of the things that I want to get into as far as the, you know, the mechanics of getting video out there is just get out of your own way. Start. It's like Rob was saying before the show, there is a process. You know, you have to practice. You have to understand what it takes to get going and start moving forward into it. Just get started. And Dubb is the easiest way to get started in video. And it's the easiest way to build your workflow and get a basic workflow going. Because, and maybe Darius can expand on this a little bit, but they just released 5.0. Congratulations. I love the direction you're going, Ruben. And some of the tools that you have in Dubb can allow you the actual conversations and what I call it turning conversations into contracts. Because what happens is you start developing this relationship. You're showing up. You're doing the follow-up. You're actually being top of mind. And I have clients that I have touched base a year ago. They didn't need my services. They didn't really have any need or desire to hire me at that point in time. But a year later, because I did keep in touch with them, I did follow up with them, and I did actually engage with them, then we're doing business. You know, I booked 2 clients this week just as a result of being interactive, having some fun with them, and being personable, you know, just putting my personality out there. And I do that through video. I don't know if anybody has heard, you know, or seen some of my videos, but love to have you drop a DM or connect with me and go through that experience. I'd love to have it. So the other thing that I want to make sure that we can appreciate for Dubb is the ability to convert views into actions. And I got a slide a little bit later on that shows the exact thing that I'm talking about here, because it just blows my mind every time I put out a Dubb video and I get a response back. I don't do that. I've been doing email marketing since 1995, since the early days, and adjusting and building systems and automations, landing pages and, you know, funnels. And I have never received the kind of response from anything compared to the response that I received from Dubb. And I'm a huge fan. I'm not a paid employee of Dubb. I'm not here to promote Dubb beyond the fact that I love Dubb. I use Dubb every day and I'm in the Doors and I'm a huge fan. Hashtag love my Dubb. I really appreciate the work and effort that everybody's put into this. And so how long have you been doing this, Ruben?
Well, it started in 2018. That was when this whole thing kicked off. And the irony of this is that the office that we are in now, on the balcony, it overlooks the building. This was an Inc. 5000 company. It overlooks the building where actually Dubb was started. And it was with a team of about 200 salespeople, and they were struggling. You know, there's a lot of competition. This is an advertising agency, a lot of competition for Google Ads and for SEO and things like this. And this company, you know, got to the point of, I think they were at like $100 or $200 million in top line revenue, but they started to know that engagement was generally low, lower bookings, lower interest, lack of trust. Just a lot of ghosting, you know? And I said, listen, the answer is not to send expensive corporate gifts or try to get, you know, expensive steak dinners with martinis going. That's not the answer. You know, big expensive conferences with big fireworks show, that's not sustainable. And frankly, sometimes when people see businesses spend too much money on advertising, they say, how efficient are you? How much of my money is going towards that BMW that you just raffled away? You know, people get concerned about that. They want it to be efficient, right? Yeah. So we started to introduce video. We saw some really interesting, you know, 1-day closes, 5-digit amount deals, which is really interesting to see. General sort of interest, engagement, curiosity, replies, a lot of forwards of emails. And that's where it starts. You know, I think salespeople just need a platform. You know, they need a platform to be able to be heard and to be seen. And I think the reality is that when people receive an email message or a LinkedIn message or an SMS or a phone call, it's a stranger danger. You know, the first response is, no, I don't want to talk to you. And the unfortunate thing about that is that salespeople make the world go round. We would not have things like life insurance and home and go to, you know, great schools and nice cars and stuff if it weren't for someone guiding us, you know? So I think that, you know, at the end of the day, it's been a tremendous journey. But to answer your question, a very, very long answer to 2018.
And I want to make this interactive. I mean, I could talk all day and just, you know, shout to the mountaintops to the value that Dubb has brought to me. And I can't even express it because there's a very few pieces of software and solutions that I really gravitate toward because I'm a professional squirrel hunter and I always doing research on different platforms. And Dubb is one of these platforms that just continues to impress me and improve. You can use it, utilize it so many different ways that it's just continues to impress me. So hats off to you, Ruben, and the team, Dubb, and everybody that's involved in this process, because I just really appreciate the work that you've put into it. And it makes a difference in my life. And I think it probably makes a difference in other lives. So thank you for the work. Appreciate it.
Yeah.
Actually, one of my favorite things every day is I literally almost every day get to wake up to an email of someone saying, hey, man, you guys helped me out. Here's the result. And I'm like, all right, let's capture that story. I got two of them today, two really good ones today. Yeah. And I get to experience that every day. And that's really what's motivated us to keep going, keep building and keep improving is as we hear from our customers. You've seen it, Russ, for a long time. Been here. We take feedback. We build based on that, based on what people are needing. And you know, we're only talking about this one component of what Dubb does and in the majority of this, because that's a big concept, like the video creation concept, communicating with video. And Russ has touched on here, there's a whole bunch of other stuff that we've built. Like if you're in business, we need some type of email tool, right? Something we're going to market with, email marketing, newsletters, automations, things like that. And this is what Dubb has built. We've built it all into one tool so that you don't need multiple pieces of software. You can literally just use Dubb. You know, you don't need the MailChimp and then Infusionsoft and the other thing to trigger this and Zapier. Like you can do it all with Dubb, with one platform. And that's really what we've tried to build here. And Russ has seen it come all the way from where it was to where it is.
Yeah, and it's amazing. And I want to touch, you triggered something, Darius, that I want to bring up because Howard's in the room and Howard's a client of mine and I love his stuff. He's from ORL and he has products and services. And we shot a video and I uploaded it to Dubb and then created a landing page for him. So he has multiple videos so he can train people on talking points for his clients. Nice. So not only is it a one-to-one, but it's a one-to-many, and it's also a hosting platform that you can actually leverage in creative ways that it's limited to only to your imagination on how you can produce content with Dubb and produce outcome from that as well. So, and that's a perfect example. Somebody in the room is actually doing, you know, real world activity, working with somebody to do this. And it's just amazing to me. I just love it. So one of my favorite pieces of the puzzle though, and something that I do on a regular basis is work with your LinkedIn integration. I love all your integrations, but LinkedIn is probably one of my top performers that I can actually look to and say, this is an amazing opportunity to actually build relationships. You know, and I'll create a little video, a short little video on how to do something. And I'll send it to somebody that might be in a business of, or like somebody connects with me and they don't necessarily have a LinkedIn header. I'll shoot a little quick video on how to create a header in Canva for free and drop it in their inbox. And all of these little things are little value adds. It's like, you know, just continue to add some value. It doesn't have to necessarily mean anything other than I'm contributing to the community and I'm contributing to the cause. And Dubb just makes it so easy. And also the follow-up and the workflows that I want you to probably share a little bit about that.
I was going
to
say, I'm just going to show the LinkedIn piece here really quick. Okay.
Would you please?
So this is what we're talking about here with the integration. You guys see this little Dubb button built right into LinkedIn. This is in messages. This is in Sales Navigator, comments, anywhere you can write a message in LinkedIn, you can drop a video in faster than you can type an email. So I can record a brand new video right here and send it right through LinkedIn, or I could take an existing video and insert and share that immediately. So that's the integration he's referring to. And this same integration exists in dozens of platforms, Gmail, Outlook, LinkedIn, HubSpot, Salesforce. You're using a popular tool that probably has an integration available in it.
First time sharing this, but we're about to announce an integration into YouTube. We have a very deep integration into YouTube. You can import videos from YouTube. You can publish videos from Dubb to YouTube, like screen videos, any video really. But now the next integration, actually, Darius, I don't even know if you know about this. It was a little bit of a surprise that I made for Chris Kirkpatrick, which is an integration into YouTube that allows you to leave a video as a comment. So instead of writing a comment on a YouTube video, you can actually leave a video about using Dubb. So someone actually, in a podcast conversation, someone asked us to build that integration. Actually, I think it was about a week ago, and we built that, and I'm really excited to announce that soon.
Well, the first epiphany I had and mind-blown activity with Dubb, I was in the car, somebody was driving, and we were going someplace, and I was shot a video on my phone and dropped it into a LinkedIn comment, and it came up with the thumbnail and the GIF. And I think they've probably reduced that a little bit, but I thought, okay, if you're having a trending post that has lots of velocity going on, and you drop a couple of videos in that feed, you're going to get noticed.
That's cool.
So anyway, I love that idea, Ruben. Thanks for developing that. I want to also talk a little bit about the tracking and the ability to see some of the activities that we have in here, because I know that that's what I appreciate, because then you can actually say which videos are doing well, what kind of activity am I getting, and have they even received my proposal or my offer or my updates or anything kind of information. And I got a screen here to share that, because one of the things that I do to invite people into my funnel to be a guest on the Pirate Broadcast, and you've experienced this, Ruben, is I send them a video. And this video, I've had over 500 episodes. So I've sent this video out, if you can see this, 572 opens, 47 clicks, 476.
Okay, wow, so look at all those clicks. That's crazy. That's like a 50% click-through rate.
Have you ever had that, Darius, in an email?
That's higher than I think everything we have right now. Yeah.
I got to take a screenshot of this one.
It's pretty freaking high.
So I can't emphasize enough. If you get the right combination of the workflow, the follow-up in emails or follow-up in LinkedIn, and this is some of the things I share with my clients, is build a workflow that works and work the system. And this is the kind of results I get. I mean, I've had this single video for over 2 years, and I know that this works. And this is the same thing I can show. You know, I have more. Well, here, let me share. So out of 1,700 videos, I've had 1,600 call to actions.
Wow.
So
100% CTA.
I'm not necessarily going on, a lot of what I do is relationship-based and very targeted. I'm going to start expanding that out because I'm doing some other things. But the reality is that you have the call to action, and the click-through rate is mind-blowing. So I don't know if you want to comment on that.
There's a great metaphor in here, which is you only have one task, which is to outreach to community. And that's exactly what you're doing. And when you have that mindset of building a community based on value, that's the numbers that you get. It's a great metaphor.
There were a couple of things in here too. I saw some more technical questions, like someone asked in the QA, how does it compare to Vidyard? There's a couple of things in here. Like one of these things that's going to be really specific to some of the analytics. I do want to answer some really technical questions, but I kind of want to save them toward the end more, like about Dubb pricing and things like that. Let's save them for a nice AMA. And then the other part of this is the stats. Well, I was talking about how long should the videos be? Someone had like that. And I said, video first or email first. And one of the things I was going to say is it depends on the use case. It depends on what you're doing. So like Russ just mentioned, he's reaching out to more targeted people. Like he's not sending 10,000 videos to, 100,000 people, right? That's not the operation he's doing. But if that is something that you, closer to what you're doing, like you're prospecting, cold prospecting, and you're reaching out to hundreds of people a day, you wouldn't expect this 100% click-through rate. Like this is astronomical. But what you would expect is when you're leveraging plain text messages and reaching out that way, when you compare that to what you're going to achieve with video, that's where you're going to notice an much higher lift. You're going to see many more clicks, far more replies. This has all been studied, not by us, also by us, I mean, but by many other people that have leveraged video technology, like HubSpot, as they've done studies on this. If anyone's familiar with HubSpot, pretty big name out there. This data is out there. The fact is people prefer to watch videos. They prefer to click on videos in emails. They prefer landing pages with videos all across the board.
It's 300%, anywhere from 30 to 300%, Darius, on spending time on a page with video versus not having video.
Exactly. So, click-throughs, engagement.
Yeah.
All of it skyrockets. So
I want to do a little bit of a breakout session here, because we have Rob, and Rob has sort of tried a new effort on some of our sales prospecting. Yeah. So I'd love to just very quickly share my screen and kind of show something that Rob actually did. Rob, if you could kind of share this story. Whatever you did ultimately resulted in a lot of email opens. And I noticed there was a lot of times that in this case, she just opened your email in various locations. So there's something kind of interesting. What was the process of this prospecting video?
Yeah. So pretty much, you know, I picked up the phone, called the Ritz-Carlton Hotel. And the Ritz-Carlton Hotel is obviously known worldwide. They don't do a lot of marketing. You know, they're well known for that reason. But, you know, I had experiences in the past with the Ritz-Carlton. So I called up, asked for their marketing department. The one great thing about hospitality is they're going to help you out right away when you want to know what department you want to talk to. So put me over to...
Hospitable people, right?
Yes, very much so. So put me over to the marketing department. And this wonderful woman, Jenna, over there, we had a great just jump on the phone conversation. And my big thing is just my own personal kind of style. No matter what I'm doing, I try to make a connection. I'm sure we all try that to a certain degree. Mm-hmm. The one thing that really, really stuck through with this is there's a phrase with the Ritz-Carlton. We are ladies and gentlemen serving ladies and gentlemen. So I reminded her of that phrase and thought, what a better perfect way than to personalize the sales and catering and wedding and events experience when you're talking to a prospect than to send a one-on-one video, which is on brand for the Ritz-Carlton as far as personality and one-on-one. So she loved it. She laughed. We had a great chat. And as you can see, she opened the emails many times, and I expect her to book a one-on-one demo very soon.
Yeah, and I'll just have you guys watch this video if that's okay with you, because it's really nicely delivered. You know, this is a Dubb video landing page. We customized it with the picture of Rob, and this is Rob at home.
Hi, Jenna. This is Rob with Dubb. Good chatting with you just now. As promised, here's this video. Hello to the other Jenna and Marcus. Good to meet you. Imagine sending a video like this, personalized, out to every prospect that you're about to either call, text, or email. No one ever said, wow, what an email, what a text. No, it's about video and making this human connection. We have increased conversions by 30 to 300% with clients all across so many different industries. And I thought, what would be more perfect than the Ritz-Carlton? I used to work for the Ritz in the Marina Del Rey. We are ladies and gentlemen serving ladies and gentlemen. And what is more personalized than something like this? So I want to invite the three of you to our webinar next week. It is next Wednesday, November 3rd at 11 a.m. PST. Jenna, I said it was 3 o'clock. I was wrong about that. November 3rd, Wednesday, 11 a.m. Watch the next video. There'll be a booking link after that. And would love to see the three of you there.
And then what this is this is a classic thing that we always do. Darius can talk about this as well. It's a personalized video followed by a playlist video, which is an evergreen video. So this video is something that can be used over and over and over again. So sometimes people call these sandwich videos or bookend videos. Basically, it's a personalized video with an evergreen video to follow. So this would be an open face sandwich, in fact. And then, of course, you got to have your calls to action. So in this case, it's register for a webinar, reply with video, or just a simple link out to learn about Dubb. So.
And that goes to Michael Mack's conversation or his question in the thoughts of re-recording individual videos for each prospect versus the same video with text personalization. I like the evergreen video that talks more about, you know, the product or service that you're offering. And it's nice to be able to shoot a quick short video and then put the text, the embed text in the top of the video as well. I like that. If the reaction I get when I just personalize the text and then put the video in there by itself is not as great as when I personalize the video and let the evergreen video play afterward. Right. Is that your experience?
Yeah, I was going to say that. So I want to show you guys something really quick here, a little workflow that was designed really to get the best of both opportunities that we're talking about here. It's just described when he creates a video for one person and it's just for them, the reaction's typically better because there's no way to fake that. When you say somebody's name in a video, they're, you know, when somebody hears their name spoken, that's a trigger in your brain, right? And that's what you're getting with a video. And if you're not hearing their name, then you miss that little trigger. So here's an example of something. I'm going to pretend I want to reach out to Russ. We're already buddies, but let's just pretend. I'm going to click this button here. This is a Chrome extension and one of Dubb's tools that enables you to create really any type of video, your webcam, your screen. You could have your profile picture down there if you're having a bad hair day, whatever. And then all you have to do is click record.
Now, no hair, don't care.
Hey, Russ, I wanted to reach out because my team and I actually produced a video. It comes right after this one. And I think you're going to find it really interesting. What I wanted to share with you, I'd love to hear your feedback. And I'm looking forward to it. Thank you. So generic script I said there, right? I mean, if I needed to, I can switch over and I can say, hey, this part's really important. Let me show you some slides. Let me show you a PowerPoint presentation. Or I can say, we're going over your contract and here's why you're going to want to sign here. This is all the value of your proposal, whatever, anything we need to show visually. But that script that I just recorded, I said, hey, Russ, we made a video for you and I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. That's why I shared it just with you. You're a special guy, whatever, right? If there's a million different ways I can say that basic sentence, but the idea is, and it's truthful, I'm not just making something up. Russ, in this example, was my ICP, my ideal customer. And when I reached out to him, I know that this solution could provide value. So everything I'm saying is completely real and honest and true. Hey, we made a video for you. I'd love to hear your thoughts. So I'm going to say he gets this first part, this, hey, you know, hey, Russ. And at the end of that, it's going to automatically roll into this next video. So this one's the pre-recorded one. It has all the cool graphics and animations and transitions and all that stuff. So now I was able to get that personal. They get to hear their own name spoken. You're making that face-to-face connection, but then you're not having to repeat yourself for the minutes at a time about maybe the reason you're actually reaching out. And as someone else asked also, how much should we pitch? Again, this is not the full pitch. If you have a 30-minute demo where you're closing somebody, this is not the place for that. No. This is the home run that's going to get them into the demonstration. This is where you share with them the most important, amazing thing you probably could about why they want to talk to you in the first place. So not a lot of pitching. Like, is anything where you're talking about anything related to yourself and your product a pitch? Technically, yes, a little bit. But if you're saying, hey, I just wanted to let you know our software solution is amazing for you, grab a time on my calendar. That doesn't have the same value benefit to them. Like, what is the software? What is this thing? Why me? You know, none of those things are answered. And so that's really what that video, even in the playlist, the longer one, again, not pitching. We're not doing everything we could possibly do. It's about the value and articulating that succinctly with a home run to get them to take the next step. So there you go.
I love that, Darius, because some of the videos that you guys have created have just, I mean, they blow my mind. And I know that it's not easy. And I love the effort that you put into it. And also what it does is it plants the seed with your customer, your client, and allows them to actually engage and figure out, is this somebody that I want to deal with, or is somebody that I could possibly do business with, or at least get along with, have a conversation with, or a cup of coffee. And it accelerates that process. So you qualify people in your circle or out of your circle, you know, because if you're selling to everyone, you're selling to no one. So you need to make sure that you can qualify them as quickly as possible. So that helps automatically do that. I hope that answered your question, Michael. Maybe you could drop us a message, because that was a great explanation, Darius. Thank you.
He had a two-part there too. The second one is, yeah, that, like, what are your thoughts versus individual versus bulk or evergreen? Uh-huh. Those are our thoughts. Is the personal one's always going to get that better reaction, but using the technology, you can really save time and not have to repeat a bulk of what you're saying. So best of both worlds. The other part there, email or LinkedIn. I recommend a multi-channel approach. Mm-hmm. If you connect with someone on LinkedIn, get their email, eventually take it off of line. Maybe you add them to your subscriber list, depending on your business model. For us, it makes tremendous sense to have multiple ways to contact our clients. We send email newsletters, we do LinkedIn posts. You need to stay top of mind with your clients. So the more channels you have to communicate with them, the better. And if we're talking prospecting, it's the same thing. Maybe they didn't even check their email that week. And then they go and, you know, maybe they checked LinkedIn and then they see it in email and they're like, okay, this is, you know what I mean? Multi-channel is usually very beneficial for the majority of people. Unless your business is completely based on LinkedIn, you don't do any email marketing. Maybe that would, you know, you don't need emails. Even then, I would say start your email marketing.
Start your email.
It's only going to help. So
I know several people that are no longer on email on LinkedIn. So that's the beautiful thing about it. Dubb does not require you to fit into one box. You can, you know, use your imagination and do this. Like I was suggesting, is like just start just a piece of the puzzle. And we haven't even talked or touched on the mobile app or the CRM that's in there or the showcases that are available or the workflows that are on place or the campaigns that you can create. All of these things add to your value add. So if you start, using video, you get a piece of the puzzle in place and then you add to it and you enhance it. You don't have to get another piece of software. You don't have to go somewhere else or log into another account to get this going. You can actually do it in a single account. That's why I say that's the beauty of what takes place in Dubb. And I just want to make sure that everybody understands and appreciates how much that matters and how much that can make a difference.
You know what else that just made me realize too is the support, like how to get this thing started. I want to show you guys first a couple things that there's a lot of technology that we described, and even just the video itself, right? Just recording a video itself has some technology and hurdle to get over or whatever.
Yeah.
What I want to show you guys is when you log into Dubb, there's going to be resources on literally any channel that you are. So when you log in, there's going to be a whole series of tasks to help you get started. They're going to say, watch this tutorial, mm-hmm. install this extension, install the add-on. Then there is live trainings. I host these myself 3 times a week, Monday, Wednesday, Fridays at 10 a.m. Anyone can register for these. You don't even have to be a Dubb paying customer. You can come in and get answers, get training, get support on anything video related to our platform. So right there is live training straight to me. I will take care of you. Also, instant answers, live chat, email support, giant database of hundreds and hundreds of articles there with every answer on everything we have to offer. As I mentioned, email or chat, you can chat and email with us directly. There's articles if you prefer reading, Facebook group, discourse community, literally anywhere you need support, we are here to help you
guys. You make it so easy. Excuse. You make it so easy. I'm only on email.
We got you. Yeah. I'm only on LinkedIn or something. I'm only on Facebook. We got a Facebook group, right? We can answer questions. So that's the other super important thing here is that wherever you're at in your business journey, in your technology journey, in your skill level, your video shyness, whatever, there's some place and there's some resource here for you to get started. And we host webinars like this. We do the live trainings, as I mentioned. Anything you guys need, we're here to support. And the only obstacle, the only real one is ourselves in this case, right? We just got to get over whatever little hurdle it is and equip ourselves with the ability to grow some more.
Well, it's one of those things, Darius, that I always tell people. It's every musician starts out at the first note,
right?
You know, it's first, not everybody achieves greatness by doing nothing but thinking. You know, they have to actually take action. So I encourage you to take action, sign up for the trial and dive in.
The free trial. I mean, you can't literally, what's the risk? Because I guarantee if you send 10 videos to 10 people and you send 10 emails to 10 people, you're going to get positive responses from videos more so than you will with the emails. And you scale that up, send 100 and send 100. Again, the effort you're going to put in, you're going to realize far more return on your time when you're putting in video, especially as you get better, especially as you adapt some of the technology that's there, the automations, the workflows. So you don't have to send manual emails again. I got to do this 30 seconds here on this one with the automation part. I just want to show you guys a visual of what this actually looks like, because if you sign up to Dubb, you will actually receive these email and text message automations. So like, we don't have a team of people that are sending these emails and text messaging all these, you know, thousands of contacts that are triggered on our platform. We actually use our technology just like you can today. So someone comes into your mix, 10 minutes later, they get a text message. And then one day later, they get an email or any shape or form of this action that you want to happen. Maybe they watch one of your videos or they click a button that says, I'm interested. Mm-hmm. If they click that button, then you can send them a whole different series of actions. You can create deals for them, like a visual deal board or a task to follow up with them because they clicked the button. Literally, you can automate so many aspects of your business with Dubb, just like we have, because we're a lean team here. And we're not a team of 100, but our automations and our sequences and our technology allow us to perform at a much higher volume, right? People are getting followed up with based on what they're doing. People are getting the messages in a timely manner without one of us having to play catch up every day and send signups to emails. So our emails to signups. So that's the other part of the whole thing. And the little visual is the next step.
And I love what you've done with the workflows. And I'm not by any stretch all caught up on everything that I would love to do. I have it on my roadmap. However, that's the beauty of Dubb is you can use pieces of the solution and continue to grow with it. And that's what I think it's. And this isn't a theory. This is something I do every day. This is something that I've done continuously, you know, booking clients and booking guests on the show, follow up and automation. And all these things are part of the process that you just have to grow into. So, but I'm really excited. I got a few more slides here. Like I said, this is not a theory. This is something I've done every day. And you don't have to make it complicated because it's not difficult. Make it simple. You have the resources. You have the ability. Reach out to me. I'm always available. I coach on this stuff. But the benefits of video are, you know, like we started out with, more people watch it. You get better interaction. You've seen the results. Putting video, hosting video on your website actually gets a lot more views and a lot more time on your pages. And we can go over that ad nauseum. But benefits of Dubb, it's a simple way to create video. It's a simple way to build your systems and build a workflow that works for you. Great way to follow up and solution to develop leads and create these workflows that support revenue generation is that the most thing. And everybody has a gift. Everybody has a message. I have to reemphasize this every day because there's a lot of people out there that are looking for your support, your experience. Nobody has your experience. Nobody has your aptitude or your attitude. So putting yourself out there, and this is a lesson I have to wake up and teach myself every day as well, is put yourself out there and help as many people as you can, because my mission in life is to help more people. And I think that that's something that we can all be part of and participate in. So I want anything that you have or anything that you want to do going forward, I think it's really important that we work together on this. And I just want to applaud Darius, Ruben, the team, Rob, everybody at Dubb and everything that's going on with. And with that, I want to answer some questions and come back and share some other stories if we can.
I wanted to quickly just kind of bounce off that and say that we are all living the hero's story. This is all the hero's journey. Every single one of us, we are on a journey. We are on a path. We are overcoming struggles. We're dealing with trials and tribulations, and we're trying to ultimately get to happiness, to love, to acceptance, to, you know, providing value, that warm kind of cushy place that, you know, we can all eventually get to, or if we're not already there right now. So what I think is really amazing about this hero's journey is the fact that in every hero's journey and every story ever told about a hero, there's a guide. There's a guide. It's the Merlin. It's the wizard. It's the, you know, in the Bible, it's the three kings. Every single religious text has the guide. It's Moses. It's Abraham. Harry Potter is Professor Dumbledore. In Aladdin, it's the genie. In Matrix, it's the Morpheus. Karate Kid, it's Mr. Miyagi. The list goes on. Folks, I wanted to tell you that right now you have an opportunity to work with a guide. Okay. And this guide is named Mr. Russ Johns. He is an expert at this platform. He's been in and out of it for years now. He's used it for so many different use cases, whether it's prospecting or nurturing or client comm or getting folks to be on the Pirate Broadcast, which is an amazing podcast that I encourage you guys to check out. Whatever the use case, he's found some success in it. And I think what's really special about what we can learn from Russ is this idea that we are all in fact creative, and we're all in fact unique, and we have something to bring to the table. My friend Rob here says that we are a fingerprint. All of us are a little bit different, and that makes it so that we literally have zero competitors. If we just put our best stuff forward and we figure out what we're good at, but we're also not good at, and by leaning into those things, it's amazing what type of connections you can create if you can just figure out a way to get comfortable sharing those stories on video.
Yeah, I have to amplify that message, Ruben, because I've watched you over the years continue to grow and evolve in practice, and you've done some great videos. And Rob, like I said, Mr. Rogers video was, I loved it. And all of these things are, and I love the statement, you are a fingerprint. You know, you have a message, you have a gift, you have a talent that is always going to be unique to you. And there are people out there waiting to hear that message from you. And if you're willing to share and open up, you know, magic can happen, because we're all here in this world, we're flying through the universe in the same planet here. So work together, support each other. You don't know what anybody's going through. So, you know, remember that, like I said, kindness is cool and smiles are free. So just put your best foot forward and hop on Dubb and ask for help. That's my message.
That's awesome. I was going to say too, that the support I was talking about is really particular to just our platform. Like you have Dubb related questions. That's our chat support and email support. Don't come to us asking about your LinkedIn profile. We don't know who can.
That would be my.
Anything else, business, anything else, our guide here, Russ, will definitely take care of you. If it's about Dubb, how do I upload my logo? Don't bother Russ with that. Come bother us with that. So, that's what I meant there, yeah.
Real quick, there's two questions that we can address real quick. Yeah. Rob, I actually have these two questions for you. So one of the ideas that we talked about was this idea of, should we send a generic video or should we send a personalized video? So this is a concept that we have been working through, which is the proof of life concept. I'd love to have you take us through this and what problem it solves.
Yeah. So a lot of the times, you know, when you reach out to someone in life in general, you love to get that, what's it called? Yeah. The response. You love to get some kind of pulse, or are you alive? Are you out there? Is this a correct email address? Is this even the right person? So that's just the bare minimum of what you'd like to get. So, you know, one of the cool things with, you know, with Dubb, and Darius has talked about this so much, you know, because this is his area, and also YouTube, you know, Russ, is the analytical side of it. You know, how many times did they look at the email? You know, like Ruben talked about earlier, you know, how many times did they open it? Did they respond? What did they do? Did they look at it? Did they click through? All that great stuff. Your stats were amazing. So when we were going over these videos in terms of sending them out, the proof of life leads you down the road of how to respond, you know, because if you have someone out there that's clicked through and they've watched your video 100%, wow. I mean, that's right on the plate right there. So proof of life is you are very alive. And then you have different gradations of it in terms of the click-throughs and things like that. But the whole point is you want to put your effort towards that as a goal. Proof of life means the next step. And this is all about steps, even the workflows. That's what it's about. Next step, next step, next step. So it's incredibly important. So have that concept in your mind. Think, what can I do when I'm writing these things, sending the videos? Where is my proof of life? And that will guide you in the right direction.
Nice. Like you mentioned there is to, once you've affirmed proof of life, right? You've gotten that hand wave, you've gotten something, this is like what I was mentioning earlier too, that outreach. If you have a lot of volume to do, 10,000 people to reach out to, that's a little difficult to do one-to-one, right? Even with the playlist thing that I showed you, 10,000 of those will take time. So the other concept here is through bulk or marketing automation, right? Where you're sending out something more bulk. This is not the concept that we were starting with that personalized approach, but it is a way to that you can filter through larger volumes of data. So you can send one proof of lifestyle video out there, and the people that engage, the people that respond to that, that then becomes your sub segment for follow-up and for your next steps, like you put it. So that's that proof of life campaign where you're sub targeting people based on their little hand raises. One other thing here too, Howard, I want to make sure you don't get left alone there. What's the main difference between Vidyard and Dubb? So here it is in a nutshell. Vidyard and Dubb have some similar creation tools. Dubb has quite a few additions that Vidyard does not have, including some of the stuff on the Chrome extension, like that resize feature. The mobile app is far more robust. So there's a few advantages to recording. The primary difference is in the page customizations. So when I showed you guys today, when I clicked record on Russ's LinkedIn and it built that whole landing page with those playlists and those buttons, that's a unique feature that you're not going to get with Vidyard unless you have a giant enterprise account and a marketing team building those pages for you. So that's the other difference there. And finally, the last thing is the built-in marketing automation platform that I showed you, the ability to send out bulk emails, bulk text messages, automated series of emails and text messages. Those are all also unique to Dubb. Vidyard doesn't offer any type of sending functions. It's just record the video and send it through your own stuff. So there you go. That's the main difference. And our team's cooler. Yeah. I don't know. I can't say. They have their own team.
Much cooler team. I can say that. I can say that.
There you go. All right.
Is there any other questions that we haven't answered or we need to answer?
How to script your first video. Now, Rob, you've done some scripting. Russ, I'd like to get your take on this as well. Who wants to go first?
Go ahead, Rob.
So the biggest thing, you know, in the world we live today, there are so many places to do the research, and research should be done anyway, but we have so many areas and arenas to dive in and find out about a prospect, about their company, their background, all kinds of good stuff. So, you know, Russ, when you talked about earlier about, you know, the responses you would get when you do that personalized video, right? So you want to have a couple things in your script that you refer to their company, refer to themselves, something that can make a connection to what they're doing. So I think it's all about taking those first couple lines and really addressing and find there what's a way to bring up what they do and incorporate it into what I want to say. So, you know, just the research end of things, take the time, find a one or two phrase little bit that you can put in there that makes that connection, kind of like I mentioned with the Ritz-Carlton, and then you can build it out from there. But that's the starting point of where you want to be.
Well, and that was the beauty of what Darius explained earlier with being on the screen with someone's profile indicating, hey, I loved what your profile said. I enjoy and appreciate some of the things you're talking about in your posts. I would love to extend the invitation to connect, collaborate on something if you're open to it. Book a call. So boom, done. And then follow up, you know, for a LinkedIn hack for everybody that is here is bookmark their post page. And so you can actually go back and so you like if you have a hot 100 or somebody that you're wanting to build a relationship with, you put them in a post, but that post page so you can go back to their post every few days and actually go through and respond to their comments. It's a great way to get notified and identify their what they're focused on.
Bookmarks, because that happens to me all the time. I'll respond to somebody's thing and then I'll totally forget about that. Maybe they responded to my thing and I got to go follow back. Nope. I'm like, I do the one comment and then I totally space it off. So yeah. Bookmarks. All right.
Yeah. Anything else, Darius, you see outstanding there?
I think that was good for questions. Unless anyone else has one more thing, I sent a question in the QA. Oh, Mike, got a last thing. How important is it to introduce yourself first in a cold personalized video? So if it's cold and personalized, I would always say, hey, it's Darius from blah, 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 right? I mean, introduce yourself just like you would if you were in person. And that's the other thing really important here, guys, is who you are on video is the same person you have to be in real life. So don't try to be someone that you're not. Like I got my Dubb crew on here. Like this is how I dress for work. If I came to the office, if I sat here, so I'm not going to like put on a suit and things like that and become someone that I'm not for this. And Dubb crew and... So you, like you said, for yourself, is Russ the type of guy to come put on a top hat and a thing and do this? And it's like that, maybe sometimes, but not most of the time, right? He is who he is. And so we encourage you to do the same thing in video. be yourself. If you ever met your clients hand to hand, or I mean face to face, and shook their hand, how would you present yourself there? If you are the type of person like a lady and you have full makeup and you want to do everything, if that's how you present yourself to your clients and that's how you feel comfortable, by all means, why would you change that about yourself because you're going to do something on video? So
yeah,
be yourself. And as far as that, you wouldn't walk up to someone and say, hey, I'm going to introduce my services. You know, you'd say, hey, this is my name. Nice to meet you. And then go from there. Yeah. So just be casual and do the things that you would normally do in person. Try to replicate that.
Fantastic. Well, I've had a great time, Ruben, Darius, Rob. Thank you so much. I really appreciate, like I said, you know, you got a fan for life, and I just want to make sure that everybody knows what is possible with Dubb. And if you have an opportunity, you know, I have courses and classes and teaching and coaching and all that kind of stuff that goes along with it. So if you want to extend an invitation, I'm open to connect. I'm open to collaborate on projects and share some of the nuggets of knowledge that we have out here, and more than happy to help out where I can.